Ники. О, Боже. Дорогие коллеги, мы рады приветствовать вас на очередной питч-сессии сегодняшнего дня. Питч-сессия, как и все две предыдущие, проходит в рамках конкурса Startup Village, в котором финалисты и победители смогут получить призы, а также засветиться и познакомиться с партнерами, с потенциальными инвесторами. И наша следующая сессия посвящена онкологическим заболеваниям, будет включать в себя проекты, связанные с диагностикой и лечением онкологических заболеваний. Прежде чем мы начнем, я хотела бы в двух словах повторить правила. Они ничем не отличаются от предшествующих, но на всякий случай для тех, кто к нам только что присоединился, каждый.
And so then 3 minutes, only 3 minutes each. So then I will warn you when your 3 minutes are up. So then the jury, and if there is any time, then we. To introduce our jury to you, which this year we are. So we have different specialists, professionals. Oncological projects from different angles. So we have investors here. We have doctors, clinicists, scientists, allow me to quickly, naturally, then the industry specialists as well. Let me introduce them one by one. Evgeny Zaitsev is a managing partner of Rosnano MedInvest. Chris Janssen is a director of Innovative Center of Johnson & Johnson. Lisa Kennedy. Lisa Kennedy, for many years, has headed GE Health Economics, presently she is the founder and general director of her own company. Which deals with the promotion of and helping startups. Dr. Soma, who last year, for 2 years, so he's coming, he joins us the second year already. He's an oncologist and a surgeon, practicing surgery professional with great deal of experience with lots of patients. Samsonov, second year with us. Mikhail Samsonov is the medical director of Air Farm. German Schipulin is the director of molecular diagnostics of Epidemiological Institute of Rospotrebnadzor. He has been involved in the diagnostics of oncological diseases program. Sandra Balensky, Veron Baisansis, Alexander has a huge experience, immense experience from the viewpoint of business and science and R&D in many companies. Gurkov, Ross Parkins Institute, the United States of America, Andre, second year with us. Represents the scientific community with our jury. I think that you are second year with us, Vladimir Tesov, General Director of Auto Partners, he represents investors naturally here, and then the management under his management, lots of startups and projects in the oncology sphere. Could you introduce yourself? I'm a coordinator of expert community at PhD technical. Fred is with us. Fred is a general director of Award of Russia. He is working on the selection of projects that later could get a Galiana Award, theoretically. So welcome, Fred. You see the jury is quite numerous, versatile, and very professional. So you'll have an opportunity not only to listen to a lot of presentations at the same time, just to talk to the specialists of the highest order who have been involved in this problem for many years. Let's move over to the first project. Vladislav Vileyka represents CSB Genomics, resident of Skolkovo, so please 4 minutes. Allow me to give you a background. That's how we eventually made the breakthrough and eventually decided to use the platform properly for novel biomarkers. So we managed to do it eventually and made a good progress. 50 years ago, the scientists looked at biomarkers with crucial restrictions to forecast the efficiency of therapy. And so then the circulating DNA liquid biopsy is suitable for many things. And the fundamental nature of circulating DNA, because the biomarkers the origin is very low content, less than 0.1% biomarker DNA, so which is very difficult to detect with standard methods. And then the fragmentation as well is another restriction constraint that increases the problems in analyzing it with the help of a PCRs. So that's why this fragmentation approach, we did it jointly with our colleagues from the Oregon Health Science University, and we developed this new concept in the analysis of the circulating DNA, which provides research of the fragmentation pattern reflects gene expression status. So we developed these new methods of data analysis. So we got some promising results and phenomenon that are part of the concept now. Because then the fragmentation pattern, its characteristics are closely related with the activity of the expression of genes, including in tumors. That allows to analyze this pattern as a source of biomarker information. The distribution of different fragments in blood is not random and fluctuates from whereas within 1,000-fold range, which allows to analyze the changes of 1% DNA if you select the right location where the coverage will be minimum. And the last very important consideration is that the fragmentation pattern is related to the regulatory fragmentation associated with regulatory chromatin, which is a companion DX for epigenetic drugs. And that's why new diagnostic methods will be required. Eventually, the challenge what actually stood in the way. So we transformed it in number of opportunities. So the ease of easy to find, easy to detect, with the help of PCR. And the nature of those markers is not only associated with development of pathology like prostate-specific antigens, but it allows to look for new biomarker targets. And it's a new universal platform for a wide range of applications of cancer, neurodegenerative, and aging biomarkers, et cetera. And so then the proof of concept that we are finishing up now that will allow us to develop biomarker panels. So the research work and validation of those markers will require $800,000, and maybe simultaneously we'll look for companion diagnostics for such inhibitors, different inhibitors. Our team is small, but remembering that. Members of the jury, questions. So how do you distinguish normal tumor from cancerous tumor? Fragmentation pattern inside the genes related to cancerogenesis. I mean that you, when you use inhibitors on the healthy person, then the DNA, no characteristic appearance of DNA fragmentation. Yeah, that's a potential. That's a potential wilt. So G-stone acetylase, we didn't do it yet. Excellent presentation. Can you talk about your business model? What are you planning to sell and to whom? The competences in the team. So the business model is the development of technology and sale of intellectual property and license for biomarkers companion, so on the orders of pharmaceutical companies. create intellectual property, so then you'll be selling intellectual property, IP, right, exactly. We'll be selling IP plus. Okay. No questions. Thank you, Vlad. It's the first medical university of St. Petersburg, Mr. Zaraisky. 4 minutes. Zaraisky Mikhail, I'm from St. Petersburg. Our team has developed the system for diagnosis of thyroid cancer and the regular investigation of thyroid cancer. Because the existing challenge is there, so then 15%, 20% of surgeries to remove the tumor. They had no grounds for that, and then they cut it out in a blind fashion without proper. So we do the analysis of the microRNA analysis, decreasing disability till 5%, no need for replacement therapy. So then the product line from cDNA with the miRNA specific to identify mutations in target genes, expression of microRNA, and it will all be computerized. That should be on the table of the doctor, so that should calculate the percentage of cancerogenicity and so the therapy. This computer system should be integrated into the lab system so that the doctor should see the holistic picture. And so the team is 10 persons, so work on different grants in different levels, federal target program, regional programs, local programs, and they will work very successfully. The Russian market is about $300 million. Our main customers are oncology clinics, so that's 14-16% oncology centers, hospitals, research centers. Unfortunately, so they have a dearth of projects there. These are our main competitors, Russian companies, Sequinom, NGS is our competitor, Nanostring, out of all four positions that we work on, this system do not do them all. So the software program that we're talking about is our strong point, our main advantage of our project. So now we have a prototype of all these products. So we need to raise $8 million to get them to the market, to market them and start selling. So here's our business plan starting from year two. First is development, polishing it off. Second year, we start paying back, so monetizing the investments. And so now our work going under the auspices of VVC Lab. So we have our partners here, but only partners, not investors. And we came for investments. Thank you. Once again, the price for the most laconic presentation. Concise. So the therapy standard and surgery of thyroid gland. Is there any selection opportunities? So can you select between what and what? To do a surgery or not to do surgery? Because 15% cases of all the surgery, so we remove the thyroid gland, and then later we realize there was no need to remove the thyroid gland. So that's why we need just to reduce the number of surgeries that are not actually needed. Clinical trials, how long do you think it will, how much time will be needed? In St. Petersburg, the Pirogov Hospital, 3,000 surgeries a year for thyroid dysfunction, then oncology, first medical oncology institutions. So then about 10,000 surgeries are required annually. I think that the first information concerning the statistics will come quite soon. You want to do these tests to all patients for all thyroid dysfunction? No, we do the biopsy. We do the biopsy, so half of the biopsy go to cytologists, half to us. And then we do the and the cytologists, 30%, there's no information about whether they need to do it or not, because the cytologists, when they do the examination of the biopsy, so they don't know whether there is a cancer of thyroid or not. And so we can just increase the certainty and the accuracy. So your test will show this. This is a papillary cancer, right? And so there is a group of genes that are responsible. So we raised 34%. So 60% is outside. So microRNA reduces this this percentage, and so the statistics gets much better. And there is no need to remove thyroids. So this system. So then we have the target genes, plus we consider there shouldn't no higher than 50-60%. Our target audience is the microRNA audience, which is 40% of the balance. So the patients are from the genetic examination. And so if there is no information after the cytology in the examination, no conclusive results. What is microRNA? What are the markers? What kind of microRNA markers you use? Can you name them? So negative, positive markers. Do you take the markers you know about, the known markers or not known markers? Or because to the best of my knowledge, microRNA is very actively studied and along the lines of different oncology cases. And it is true because we don't know how many microRNAs there are, and so we don't know, there's no math model. But we have an agreement with the Vitrum company, and so nanostring system will help us to do the cumulative examination of 800 positions. And from those 800 positions, we'll select the microRNAs that we're going to deal with later. And on this is 8 million rubles, and then we can get to the level of preclinical trials. Thank you. Any more questions? From the floor, tick it off against the name. So the Russian Institute of the French of the People's another diagnostics block.
Do you know how important is to diagnose skin cancer, and why do we need to do this earlier to discover such a disease? So I would like to show you some clinical examples. During 5 years, last 5 years, so here you can see the figures that so this kind of cancer increased by 4% only in Russia. And also this is so basal cell cancer is more than 1% among all cancers. We can solve this issue if we invent, if we create software express diagnostics and methods of early identification of basal cell carcinoma, and it will provide for smaller cases of recidives and lethal cases. You know that all oncology diseases are covered by insurance. All potential customers can be everybody. Oncological hospitals, dermatological cancers, and all commercial centers. Only in Russia, we registered more than 7,500 of such hospitals. So on this slide, we have a table of methods of cancer diagnostics, which we have for this period of time. Our project, FAS diagnostics, in comparison with the current method of diagnostics, doesn't have any analogy on efficiency or quality of diagnostics. And our diagnostics is unique, and this is an express one. Advantage of our product. Diagnostics is done in the mode of real time. It's visual. With the help of software, we can look for archive and database. Diagnostics, this is conducted in real time. With the software, we can make a 3D module of tumor, and this can provide verification of this diagnosis on the part of patient. It's also convenient, it's not invasive of this diagnostics. Our motto, happiness is to be healthy. Our team consists of highly professional scientists and economists also. We have a rich experience and about 75 inventions, 60 patents, more than 70 publications and articles. Our scientific expected plan, on the first stage we have research, the second stage we create a pilot sample and then commercial introduction of technological in hospitals of this product. Thank you very much and be healthy. Thank you, Ekaterina. You did not mention about the technology itself. This is a combination of optic technologies and laser technologies. And also, this is describing of multi-lens optical system, laser emitter in the spectra of ECA emitter. With the help of this data, we will discover the component of a tumor, movable and not movable, and we'll define the degree of blood circulation of all epithel tumors. The basal cell carcinoma, this is very widely spread, and usually this is neck and also the head area. Yes, blood circulation is important, and also some specific signs. And how specific is it for basal cell cancer? This is a part of our know-how, and gave this for registration of patent rights. That's why we discovered earlier signs which can characterize this vessel tumors. And this is very specific things. We can verify diagnosis morphologically, and we can verify this in real time within 2-3 minutes. Thank you very much. Ekaterina, and how does this technology differ from confront tomography? We make a 3D model, and we can see blood circulation and some specific signs. What about morphology of cells? Do you see morphology of cells? Now all our research we conduct with correlation of immunodistochemia, and we have research correlation with immunodistochemia. This can be not relative to your technology. This is your comparison, benchmarking. Yes, because we want to see specifics. What is it, how is it different from confocal microscopy, which already exists in the world? And it's used, it's not used, unfortunately, in Russia. Maybe somewhere it's used in Russia, but practically no. But in Europe, it's commonplace. And for me, I don't understand what is the difference. Why do we need this high level of investments? Because the majority of these tumors at the early stages, they can be treated with one of the methods, surgical or career destruction or laser or combination of these methods. But those horrible pictures you show, they are very seldom, but of course they exist. But when we have this picture, your diagnosis is not needed already, you know. Yes, I emphasize on early diagnosis. Basal cell can be relative to epithelial tumors, and it can be applied for all epithelial tumors. But can you explain to us how technologically it's different from chaotic microscopy? As I know, in the technology of microscopy, it does not give the characteristics of blood circulation and 3D model of tumor. And it exists, but it's not perfect. But not. But also here, not machine does it, or you have a computer program which can do this all. We have a software, and it's automatically. It automatically can identify signs, specific signs, indicators for epithelial tumors, and in this case, we can create graphs. We can have results of diagnosis. Thank you very much. It's time already. We don't have any time for questions. Now another project, Gamma-Locato project. Vladimir, you have only 4 minutes. Good afternoon. My name is Vladimir. I present Engineering Center near MIFI. I would like to tell you about one of our projects. This is our medical project, a gamma locator. And this is intraoperational diagnostics for cancer oncological surgery. Here you have figures, and this is statistics. This is International Cancer Fund. Here, 12 million, this is death from oncological diseases per year. Here we have problems. This method of diagnostics, which are applied traditionally, they are not very precise for surgeries or some equipment which we need to exploit. It's very sometimes it's very expensive, and that's why surgical operation. For example, not enough volume of lymph nodes are cut away. It's not enough. Too much is also not enough. We made a device which is called Gamma Locator on the basis of Rosatom company, and we focus on developments also of nuclear technologies. Gamma Locator, this is autonomous device which can understand which lymph nodes can be cut away and which should not be done. Cut away. Before surgery, we implement a radiopharm device. It's concentrated lymph nodes. This gamma locator can be touched on lymph node during the surgery, and it can beep or it does not beep. This is lightweight, easy to use, practically no expenditure, only the device itself. Here you can see what it contains from. So here we can see a radiopharm devices, and then gamma locator itself, USB cable. Technology is very simple. We use scintillator, which turns gamma quantums into photons, and with the help of photo device, we detect them. We used some developments in nuclear medical researchers, and we have very good characteristics. Where can we use it? The main application is during the surgery detect only what we need to cut away. It can be used for skin cancer also. It can be used also everywhere practically, and we can use it even for detection of emission. So not medical application also can be done. Here you can see technical characteristics in comparison with our competitiveness. Price is also very good. So the market estimations, the volume of the world market, and the structure of price for the product. Here investment, we need 22 million, and so of course there can be grant program, or maybe we won't have grant program. We can have the share of investment. And the investment indicator in the horizon of 10 years. This is a business plan for 10 years. A roadmap. We have prototype, and we need to commercialize this. We have a team. And that's all, Vladimir, because 4 minutes. What about sensitivity? For example, the size of metastasis of tumor, or you can change standards of surgeon. For example, if a surgeon won't remove lymph nodes, there is a risk. Why do we need to have them? Can you help me with a clicker, please? So here characteristics. So here, spacious resolution 8 millimeters, and device stop to beep. Sensitivity 26 degrees. I don't ask you about this. I ask about the size of tumor. If it's a micro tumor, for example, 124 cells, would you see it or not? I'm not ready to answer this question. Our technicians can answer this question. I have some general information only, and I have not spoken to doctors, but they say this is very promising, but I don't have this information. It's actually very necessary, very needed. In Russia, unfortunately, we practically don't use it. But you need to explain it very differently. And in this case, Andrei won't ask his question, because this device is needed. And as you put it right, it can be used for biopsy of stroma lymph nodes for analyzing, especially speaking about melanoma and the cancer of breasts. So this is applicable in the whole world besides Russia. And did you estimate a practicality of usage of this device in Russian conditions? What do I mean here? You understand that if a clinic can buy this device, they need a lab. They need isotope testing as a minimum, a gamma camera. Yeah, they need installation. And how many institutions potentially can do this, which they can buy this device? And where, how do you think, maybe surgeons can be interested? You know, so MIFI Onco Center is very nearby, and they have these devices already. Onco Clinic, very large in Russia, they exist also. They have these devices. And we can use it, so we can also deliver this within 3 hours till other clinics. And we also have our markets in Singapore, and they are also very interested in this device. And they want to invest in this project and develop it in Singapore and in Asia. Now, speaking about these figures in your table, if they are true, yes, of course, you have some special advantage in the world, not only in Russia, but you need to find those teams. Not only one team you need, not only in one Onco center, but several teams which can test this all and they can improve it all. We are working at it now. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Now we are moving to another project, Sibnero. Gleb Sergeyev will speak about it. I would like to introduce my project, Brain Target. We did not know where to present this project because we do not only medical things, but we develop software to estimate efficiency of neurosurgical operations efficiency. It's not a secret that many tumors in brains are removed annually, and also there is the prevalence of brain glioma, and it affects young people. What is the problem here? The estimation of quality of tumor removal is done visually only by the surgeon. He can do this only visually. And the differences of estimation of specialists are very high. That's why on this picture, in this picture, on MRT picture, you can see, for example, intensity of a tumor and some other things are the same. In Russia, we do 50,000 operations annually, and our price 1,500 rubles per patient. We would like to have 25 million and per 1 year, for 2 years 50 million, 3 years 125 million. And we also then involve insurance companies, and they will help us also here in this market, and of course international market. What is here the essence of this? With the help of our software, we can precisely to understand the remnants of the tumor, and when we have vessel pathology, we treat these pathologies intravascularly with the help of some special solutions into these vessels. And if a surgeon exceeded its 60% of embolization, it can give it can have a complication, and we can monitor all this and help the surgeon. What is the main thing here? It's very simple, precise, and accurate. We will do this with the help of web services. If it's a tumor, if it's vessel pathology, this is software which is implemented in the equipment. Team, R&D director, Alexei Kirilo-Shapkin, me, I'm a co-founder, Gleb Sergeyev, algorithms developer, and we have also Leonid Kalneus, co-founder, software engineer. We have 5 publications, and one is an English software prototype and patent. We need 5 million. We will spend it for all this project and advertising promotion. We have clinical basis. This is the basis on programming, and you can see all of them here. Mikhail, question, please. Gleb, thank you very much. It was very interesting for me. This is IT program. This is software. You did not mention about competitors. For today, we have 4 competitors, and these competitors, they are visualizers of MRT shoots, but we offer practical information, remnants of a tumor, because from these remnants we'll have repetition of this disease, and also vessel complications. And did you have some first results? Yes, we are very specific here, and our software has 90% of accuracy, and this is necessary for us. Speaking about analogs, they have all different things. Tumor and hematological stuff, some other companies, they have together as one mass, and we separate these things. What about specifics? Did you prove it morphologically, or how did you do this? How do you plan to show it? You know that neurosurgical operation is aimed at removal of some part of tumor which accumulates MRT contrast agent, but we cannot remove whole brain, of course. Know that some cells are somewhere widely spread in all brain. We have neuro navigation results, and we compare these areas. Some other questions, maybe? Okay, please tell me, how do you manage to achieve with this software what other large manufacturers could not achieve, as Siemens and Philips, for example? Because if we take only ultrasound researchers, if today we speak with two great experts, they will give us different conclusions. One would prefer one device, and another would prefer another device. And this is already mostly like a habit. It's not like an advantage already of this technology. But for me, it's not convincing. With the help of your software, you manage to differ what morphological doctors cannot do. We do not define gestological diagnosis. We are surgeons, and we aim at this contrast agent. We need to remove this high intensity during the surgery, but sometimes we fail. And the same intensity we can see in blood in some hours, and gestological agent, and we need to we need to separate these things. I cannot hear the question, unfortunately. What about edema? Edema cannot have the signal. It can have only hyper-intensive signal. It does not prevent us from detecting this. And then edema goes away, and we got the result with our software. Thank you very much. Now we proceed. Gleb, thank you very much. Our next speaker, this is Alexander Fokin. Alexander Fokin, I present Miropa, and our team has a novel gene pathway analysis tool for personalized cancer medicine, and we focus on oncology here. In different countries, each fifth person dies from cancer, and we tried to fight this problem, and we also decided to involve in this fight. We created Miropa. This is a database on molecular interaction, and this is a tool for analyzing of gene networks for personalized medicine. Clinical therapy on cancer is efficient only in 30% of cases. $60 billion is spent just in vain because it's not efficient. When we develop medications, pharmaceutical companies try to solve these important issues, and they look for diagnostic biomarkers, try to define how gene regulation change inside of the network and some precise mutations. What other devices do we have and how efficient are they, if you want to compare this method with already existent? So here we have quite a big market of this medications. More than 1,000 companies develop these medications against cancer. And for them, it's very important to understand this effect which can be caused by their medication, some drugs. Sometimes it can be toxic, even indirectly, and they need to analyze a lot of articles and publications for detecting this information. Now I speak about a lot more about the product itself. We created one of the biggest database on RNK, And speaking about free database, this is a large one on MicroAmerica. And our tool was gathered together with five annotators manually during some years. They were looking for this data. Our tool is in cloud. We have also public version of this product. It's available. You can use it. And some researchers from different countries of the world, they go to this database and they can monitor also all this. Our team, you can see here four people. Of course, there are more than 10 of us, but these are our key employees. Here you can see also we have also experts. The Alexey Kulikov, Doctor of Science, 22 years genetics and system biology experience. I'm here for you to get advice, to get acquainted with you, and also we would like to create a box version for pharma. We need only to add some content here and functions. I think for this we need about 1 year of work and 7 million of rubles. Okay. Thank you, Alexander. Now questions, please. Colleagues, maybe from the audience, Evgeny. Alexander, can you tell us where do you take data from? Our employees, they read medical publications, then they formalize this data, we have our own database also, and it is dedicated to oncology and medications and drugs. So your customers, they are drug developers, yes, and value. What about value proposition for them? Sorry for my that I speak English. It's evident that we can simplify research and also reduce cost of this research and period for drugs. So the system can automatically calculate what it can be as a result.
The system gives recommendations and prompts you, but the decision is made by the developer. So because the system cannot tell what to do, because it will give you different papers, so then cellular lines in oncology research, and then the researcher thinks, and so then he is just trying to figure out how to impact the target. And so if he is interested, then he can just look for specific info. How are you going to sell? Through internet, via internet, we have it all in the cloud. In the cloud. So, for example, I'm a user. Who should I pay and for what? So then subscription for the database, it will be updated every day. And how much will it cost? For pharmaceuticals, $15,000 a quarter. For 3 months, $15,000. Okay. Two more questions. So you failed to talk about the competition. So there are two big whales of competitors. Jingo, that was sold to Thomson Reuters, Tacor products, and Stanford company Ingenuity, that was purchased by Coagen, European company. It was bought by them. So these two companies, they're better than us along many parameters. And that's why we decided to narrow down to oncology. We concentrate to so these are our jokers, our aces up our sleeves, and so we do only the validated interaction. So we sift out, so we do this the guaranteed transduction, and we take out only the information that we're sure about.
All companies to talk about your project?
No, don't have.
Thank you. Thank you. So our time is up. Alexander, thank you. We move over to the next project. And to a great extent, we'll talk about treatment issues in the first project is Les Quantum, Andrei Lomonosov. Good afternoon. Thank you for a chance to talk about my project, evolutionary method of a precise target chemotherapy, non-surgical electrochemotherapy of inoperable and metastatic and aggressive chemo-resistant tumors. My name is Andrei Lomonosov. I work for COO Quantum, and we designed this technology recently. So what's the main challenge? Cancer is the main challenge. What cancer is associated with? It's a long, painstaking, potentially mortal condition. So the figures prove that point. So 20% mortality, 20% complications, and long therapy is 50 days. If you look at the incidence rates in the United States, a million, and in Russia, no less than that. And the price is quite, you know, more than $40,000 for treatment. And all the methods, classical surgery and new non-invasive methods, so hospitalization, long hospital stay, side effects, and the therapy is very long. And our team tried to develop a new chemotherapy method, targeted, which makes it fast with little side effects and very efficient and quick. So we're talking not only about hospitals, and but this method is good for outpatient clinics, and outpatient clinics may use this method as well. So this is the breakthrough. What's the essence of this know-how? So through electrodes, so we insert, we make it, we deliver the drug, so then the tumor, we delivered electrophoresis, hypothermal, impacting with bipolar probes. And then hypothermia, electrophoresis, and then we identify the chemo resistance of the drug, of the tumor. And once we identify, so it could be done with local anesthesia in 1 hour, and allows to kill a tumor with a diameter of 50 millimeters. So they show the efficiency, several tests. And without any surgical involvement, no intervention, so radiotherapy is a final step. So then the survival rate is 98 persons out of, so the survival rate within 5 year time is 84, 400. So then what's good about the system? So we certainly were looking for cooperation with the big pharmaceutical company, because our method allows to use very toxic but very efficient targeted methods of treatment, and in the hospital and outpatient as well. And efficacy is quite considerable, and in private clinics as well. So we have an excellent team from the American University and from other universities, so very strong professional team. We're looking for, we need $1 million, to make a long story short. So to develop a prototype and to do the clinical trial and to do some animal tests. And so we, in 5 years, by 2020, so the sales will go over $1 million. Thank you. Questions? Question. What's the novelty? What's the groundbreaking point? So the combination of three types of application: chemotherapy, local chemotherapy, targeted electrophoresis, then hyperthermy and electroporation. So this combination of three plus targeted method of delivery. Simultaneously you deliver, so it's one method, delivery is one method. So locally through a set of probes, bipolar electrodes. But the drug will get to the tumor, but the concentration So if you do it in a different type of delivery, then you will do the kind of carpet bombing. But this is will be targeted, pinpoint. And electrophoresis is needed for the drug because it's charged, physiologically charged. So we need just to make sure that the delivery goes straight to the target and pinpoints the tumor. And so, but you delivered it to the center of the tumor. What else you do need to do? So you're done. You need just to contain it there. Yes, we need to contain the drug. So a clinical study shows that this electrophoresis method adds to deficiency because the immune system gets gets connected as well and kicks in, and that enhances the efficiency of the drug delivered. The issue how to protect the patient and how to protect your design with the patent. So we are looking, so in the United States, quite expensive to submit a patent, and now we do the BST on this patent. That's the issue. So is patent enough to guarantee the exclusivity of your innovative solution in the market or not, so that it could be part of the claim patent? Judging by the patent-based search that we have, and we have gone through it so that, by the time of submission, so that allowed us to make this uniqueness of our technology is protected. It's after all, it's protected. You failed to speak about competition. This technology has been used for a while already. Not all together, not all three components together. Some use hyperthermy, some use high current electroporation or ablation of the tumor, but no one uses the combination of all three. So what kind of tumors you can use this method on? Because not all tumors are susceptible. Our main opportunity is the tumor of the muscle tissues, not very deep. Second type of tumors, pulmonary tumors, and then maybe some deeper organs, organ tumors as well. But you need to find the target audience. So, for example, so the high incidence limb melanoma. So then the isolated perfusion of limbs is used, and in sarcomas they use the insulation of the limbs as well. But this is a good a candidate for your kind of treatment. But the number of patients is very limited, and they have to follow up, because the main competitor here is tumor availability. The main competitor will be surgical intervention, and you can't. So if it's if the tumors are close to the surface of the body, and when you look at instances where the surgical intervention may not work as well as yours, so then there is a technological issue, because this is a open a surgery operation, but you have to open it up, open surgery. For example, we do several punctures. Punctures of electrodes, like biopsy electrode types, and then it's only 1 hour. But what we need now is to widen so the list of tumors that we can operate on. Okay. Denis Pakhmurin with his next project, PROM-L. Denis Pakhmurin, director of PROM-L. We develop a local hyperthermia complex Phoenix 2 for oncology purposes. So oncology is widely spread. Incidence is 15 million. They're diagnosed for the first time with cancer, and 8 million die of cancer, and this is the figure. So we want to reduce this number using our equipment, our device. So this is applying heat to the tumor without damaging the healthy tissues. So we think that will take a 10 market share, so the equivalent of oncological diseases, oncology. And just talking to a number of Russian and international medical institutions, they became interested in buying our equipment. And we have a lot of competition here. And although we hope for a successful contest, because we have some specifics which make our equipment unique. We abandoned the use of harmful microwaves, unlike our competitors, and thus we managed to focus, high-precision focusing, and not impacting the healthy tissues negatively. Then we reduced the negative of chemotherapy concomitant effect, and that is why the anti-tumor effect increases three times. So only just on the surface, but deeper in the body, so any localization is possible. So the equipment is small, the power is small, it consumes less three times than a pot in the kitchen. And so then 10 times less than our competitors, and the price is much less as well. And then we need, so our competitors need to screen screen the equipment from human beings, and so then the power consumption is very high, and so this is why we are far ahead of our competition. So it can be used in large, small hospitals, clinics, outpatient units as well. Our team has many knowledgeable scientists, developers, medical engineers. All of them are PhDs, doctors, professors, and one academician even we have. And we are so we work in Tomsk, the University of Radio Electronics. Our company won several grants, and the federal grant, local grants as well. And I, as the director, I deal with not only development. And I do the commercial monetization. I take it to the market. I have both engineering degree and medical degrees, which allows me to look at things comprehensively. And so then I got trained in Europe, and our company works in with the Tomsk Oncological Institution and another medical university. So we did some tests on animals, and that showed high efficiency. And now just we're in the middle of certification process. So we plan to do the serial production and sales starting from 2015. And within the next 5 years, so we'll get to the 10% of the market that we hope to. Now we're looking for customers and partners and both. And here are our contacts. So our equipment can safer and more efficiently treat on ecological de novo formations. Very interesting, but very enigmatic. You're saying that you're abandoning microwaves. But if you abandon, what have you replaced it with, microwaves? We replace microwaves with, we generate heat with the help of current. With the help of current, and we deliver, so we heat, and then we deliver the heat with the help of current, direct current, not AC, but DC current. And so then how do you pinpoint some special location of our heaters, heating probes, so that allows to pinpoint the probes when we talk about the deep laying tumors, around which so there are healthy tissues. That is why we can heat the tumor up to 45 degrees centigrade. What is the heater? The heater is what is the heater? Is it a piece of metal or what is it? It's a piece of metal. And so, for example, if the liver is in the person's liver. So then, yes, we can do it with the help of a big needle, and so we even tested it on ourselves, not liver, but other tissues. We tested on ourselves.
There is a lot of thinking around within breast cancer that if you can ablate within a centimeter of that tumor, it could potentially, in areas that did not have a good access to radiotherapy, it could substitute for that radiotherapy. Have you thought about that as an application? So thinking about the local recurrence, usually in the breast, it comes within about a centimeter of that tumor. So I know one surgeon's looking for some interesting technologies like yours. Is this something that you could potentially do?
Вопрос вы поняли. А раки молочной железы, абляция и как замещение радиотерапии, думали ли вы о таком применении вашего метода, в частности, в раке молочной железы?
We can use our method in any tumors, not only in mammology, in any other tumors, and we use this method in accordance with in combination with chemotherapy at first, because chemotherapy gives the wide therapeutic effect, and radiotherapy gives only a local therapeutic effect. And our method has already a local effect, and we use the local chemotherapy, global chemotherapy.
Скажите, пожалуйста, вот как у того же Томского.
And this Tomsk Research Center and the Russian Center. You have a big experience business in radiotherapy and chemotherapy. Are you planning radiotherapy or just a thermal chemotherapy or radiotherapy as well? So we did some research with thermal and radiotherapy, thermal chemotherapy, but we got a thermal chemotherapy it gives us better effect. So I talked to Hertz and Institute representatives, so they're of the same opinion that the combination of chemotherapy with thermal therapy, it gives better results. But if you patent your outside Russia, if you want to, you will have to do a lot of work to convince, because thermal radiotherapy did not find good application outside the USSR. That's exactly what it did, because it's less efficient than chemotherapy. And so because we have to increase, we reduce metastasis and increase the lifespan, et cetera. Mm-hmm. But it's less efficient, it's longer. And so what's the novelty? It was a scientific hypothermal methods have been used for many years. And so the novelty is that we abandon the microwaves completely. Microwaves, like our competitors use, we don't do that anymore. And there is no need for us to have big generators, big equipment. Just the source is the only thing that's different. Because we have 6 patents right now just for different models for the means of delivery of heat. And we patented everything we could in Russia. Now we plan to patent outside Russia. Did you study the market? Because there is no room outside Russia. Absolutely. No, I talked to, everything is taken up. And I talked to from Japan, so the Hyperthermy Institute there. And in spite of their institute, so they were much interested in our method. Because it's quite groundbreaking, not only in Russia, but outside Russia as well. So they got interested. Okay. Next project is penultimate. General director of the company and developer of innovative gene therapy drug. So our drug consists of 2 components. So which is the coating and the DNA molecule, which contains coating. So which has 2 suicide gene and genetic gene. So then intravenous, the drug is injected, intravenous injections after it gets into the tumor. So then the two proteins are synthesized. So a prodrug into suicide protein and the immunostimulator protein that actually tracks the immune cells into the tumor, developing the good anti-tumor response. And so they show the safety and efficacy of this drug, because we see that the introduction of this injections or some metastatic process reduces, and the efficiency is very good. So we have no analogs. It's quite unique. So the clinical trials, so five drugs are going through the clinical trials right now. So we have the same different type of genes, but they contain only one of the genes. But our drug contains combination of genes. And so the system of delivery are used viruses, which are quite expensive and not safe and quite dangerous and difficult to produce. And thus our safety, security, reliability, delivery, and low production cost. And so we started to work on it in 2009. Presently, we have successfully done all the preclinical studies successfully in 2016. So we plan to do the clinical trials. And by 2020, so the drug will be marketed. And during preclinical trials, we identified three types of cancer that potentially could be a good target for treatment. So this is cervical, neck cancer, and colorectal cancer. So then 80 incidence is 80,000 a year. So the first year of sale, we get almost $500 million rubles, and drugs will get, then the sales will go up and up, and then we got 3.5 billion rubles eventually. And the investors, so we need just to finish the preclinical and start the clinical trials. So we need investments for that. So the main advantage of our project is our team. So then the science director is a famous member of the Russian, German, European Academies of Sciences, Mr. Sverdlov, Professor Yakubovsky. Professor has great experience in this area. And then we have laureate of Galien Award, Professor Sobolev, and business consultant John Murphy. And then the leading clinicists of the Herzen Medical Institution. So we have experience in the development of drugs, both by Sverdlov developed the first genetically engineered interferon. And the members of our team developed and marketed Insuran drug medication. So we hope that anti-onco-RAS-M will go through the clinical trials with flying colors and will contribute to treating cancer. Questions? So then genetic therapy of cancer has gone through the period when everyone loved it, and now just it goes through this So no one considers it seriously. So that's a new stage. So why? So the two issues that need to be addressed. So then tumor-specific delivery first. How do you address that issue? And then delivery to 100% of tumor cells or to the majority of cells. How you do? So we don't do the tumor specificity delivery because it's injected intra-tumor, And from the viewpoint of delivery, so we got the Galien Award for that, for the delivery system development. And so cationic modified something that's 90% level of transduction and delivery. And when you deliver it in the tumor of your medicine, how quickly necrosis occurs of the tumor. Because usually in my experience with similar drugs and clinical trials. So the basic challenge of the patients of neck cancer and brain cancer. So we deliver it. Then there is necrosis, and the main is fighting hemorrhages because it starts to bleed. And so we lose more patients from hemorrhages than from treatment. Then if without treatment, they would have survived longer. And so this, you'll have to come up face to face with this issue eventually. So this medication is not, because a toxin is released slowly. It's not a bolus release. So cytotoxic protein is formed slowly and in small quantities, and then they inject it every 5 days, three times, and we haven't seen any necrosis. So which countries are you planning to do the clinical trials? In Russia, and Herzen Institute of Oncology. A promoter on the basis of a promoter of something of human transcriptase or something. Okay, 98% delivery rate is fantastic. This is not possible. So not in vivo tests. No, we haven't. So we haven't proven yet in vivo effect. Thanks. Next, final project of the day. Felix, please, floor is yours. Good afternoon. Felix is my name. Proteome Farm project I'd like to represent in the development of a new approach in the treatment of oncological dysfunctions. So the main approach that the source of anti-cancer activity is detected in the neural network of the cerebral cortex. And so this is our know-how. The internal natural origination source of anti-cancer activity, the anti-cancer activity is exclusively a result of applying the know-how. First, let me give you the backdrop. So the idea is, so we watch this, the psychological condition of a person that could be the cause of oncological diseases. Then spontaneous remission of cancer in humans, and we're trying just to figure out why it happens, and then the placebo effect needs to be taken into account. So it's widely known, and so when the patient gets a placebo instead of a drug, he gets only information about the treatment, and so that is good enough for the treatment effect, and so we need to work on it, but it can be negative as well. So the impact is, it's a double-edged sword. Thus, we developed a special technology that answers three questions. So where this anti-cancer activity may occur, in the cerebral cortex, where it's in a synaptosome, is an isolated synaptic terminal from a neuron or someplace else, or synaptic terminals. And the second issue is at what point in time this information response occurs that steps up the.
And also, how we can provocate or activate this answer. And it was done on the basis of some tests. Here there were two groups of animals, one target group of animals under the influence of know-how, and ordinary group of animals. In each group, we obtained the synaptosomes by known methods. And then as a result, animals which got target synaptosomes, they had slowdown of tumors. And then we also developed programs together with the Institute of Biochemistry. They developed some theories of sources of anti-tumor activities. Business goals within 4 or 5 years to get a drug discovery, and then transmit this technology to pharma companies. Investments $250,000 for each year, and the whole volume till $5-6 million. The group, the team, the main one, driver. This is me, project manager, and I have experience of developing new drugs from concept to market, including R&D process. And I'm very interested. I know that Ivan Vadim is also interested in this idea. He is doctor of chemical science. Barishnikov Anatoly, doctor of medical science, professor academician, also supports this idea. And initiator is Pinigina Nina. Thank you very much. First question, please. You understand that I am, as a member of a jury, I cannot estimate your project. I know one thing, and so a magic word, I don't know. If you don't want to speak anything to us, to share with us, please don't speak at all, because we don't know what you say to this mice. You say that you won't have cancer, and the person is treated. Then secondly, synaptosome. This is powerful secretorial body. If you think that cancer is treated because a brain emits something, brain does not issue synaptosomes. It does it with another way. Synaptosomes, why synaptosomes? This is so one neuron transmits information to another one. So please, can I answer you the second question? The first question maybe you should not answer. This is not a simple question, because we try to study it. So we need the results of the research. Thank you very much. Some other questions, Felix. Thank you very much. This was our final presentation for today. I thank all speakers, participants for their preparation. I would like to announce that all winners of the sessions will be announced tomorrow at 9:30 at the main stage. Please don't be late. And you will know who will go to the final. We have only 5 minutes left. I would like to apply to the jury. Maybe jury, you would like to comment on something, or you'd like to wish to our competitors. To our participants, Andrei. I have a wish to the organizers to help presenters, and you need to give them recommendations how to make up a presentation itself, because it was evident that some presenters could not use time efficiently, because 2 minutes, for example, they dedicate sometimes that cancer should be treated, but it's evident. You know, we have training usually before such an event, but they sometimes they don't come. I would like to agree with Andrei, and also I would like to add that some presentations, sometimes maybe they could share up a lot more with us. They could focus on some main things more. In some works, there is actual information. The first part was very good, and it was very clinical, potential application. But for this, we need first, presenter, speaker should go into the main things of this, to the bottom. And then I think also some presenters, some speakers, they did not speak enough with clinical people. I would like to speak with all of you, with all speakers, once again today. Okay, 9:30 tomorrow there will be announcement of our winners today. Now a little small break, and then we'll have another session.